أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. سبحانك ربنا لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. السلام عليكم brothers and sisters and welcome. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us the blessing of today and the many days to come inshallah, especially in the month of Ramadan. Inshallah we'll continue our journey talking about the Quranic verse in Surah Al-Dhariyat, verse number 50, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ, which means run away. But don't run away from Allah, run away to Allah. Run away from this life, run away from shaitan, run away from the materialism of this life, run away from ma'asiyah, disobedience, run away from the sin, run away from the ignorance, all that run away from. Where to go? To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you are with Allah, when you are relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're going to be taken care of. And who is better than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take care of those who go to him? Our scholars, may Allah bless them, they used to say that child always rely on his father. يحتفظ الولد أو يأتي الولد في حما أبيه والمؤمن في حما ربه. That child always go to seek help by his father, and the believers always seek help by going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to their Lord. And today inshallah we're gonna take some example from being with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no worry. When you are with Allah, no sadness. When you are with Allah, no fear, no anxiety, no stress, nothing of that. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about his servants as لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. لا خوف, there is no fear from the future. ولا هم يحزنون, there is no sadness from the past. So yesterday we talked about Musa alayhi salam and his brother, when we're commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to go to Fir'aun, and they showed that they don't trust themselves. إِنَّنَا نَخَافُ أَنْ يَفْرُطَ عَلَيْنَا أَوْ أَنْ يَطْغَى. We are afraid of him, ya Rab. He might transgress, he might kill us, he might cause us in trouble. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to them, لَا تَخَافَ, do not worry. You should not fear Fir'aun. Why? إِنَّنِي مَعَكُمَا أَسْمَعُ وَأَرَى. I am gonna be with you, hearing and seeing everything. So later on, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about the same story in Surah Al-Shu'ara, verse number 62. The Quran says, فَلَمَّا تَرَاءَ الْجَمْعَانِ قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُوسَى إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ. When Musa and Harun عليهم السلام showed Fir'aun all evidence, showed him the miracles, showed him how nonsense he is, showed him that he is not God, there is a God, supreme being behind this universe, and showed him the ayah, the miracle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala manifested on their hand, the rod or the stick turned to be a huge snake, swallowing their own, their handicraft. Then Musa alayhi salam challenged Fir'aun, challenged his authority, challenged his throne. Then Fir'aun went after him And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us the scene, describing for us the scene. When Musa alayhi salam was running away from Fir'aun, and Fir'aun and his troops are following him to the sea, to the Red Sea. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَمَّا تَرَاءَ الْجَمْعَانِ قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُوسَى إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ. When the two armies, when the two groups, Pharaoh after them, and Musa and his people, the children of Israel, reach the water, reach the sea, and they started seeing each other. قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُوسَى, the followers of Musa alayhi salam said, إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ. We are done. Pharaoh is here. He is gonna take us and he is gonna do everything, you know, to us. He is gonna cut us into pieces. He gonna hang us on the trees. He gonna cut our hand, our feet. He's gonna do everything he like. قال أصحاب موسى إنا لمدركون. We are defeated. We cannot run away from him. Then Musa alayhi salam, because he trusts Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he have faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he draw his power and his support from the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then قال أصحاب موسى إنا لمدركون. What did he say? قال كلا. No way. That will never happen. Trust me. What make you so sure, Musa alayhi salam? قال كلا إن معي ربي سيهدين. إن معي ربي سيهدين. My Lord is with me. He's gonna show me the way. So there is no time really for any maneuver. There is no time to make a plan. There is no time to look into the map to see where are we and where is Fir'aun. There is no time. 1 second make a big difference. But Musa alayhi salam said, Allah, my Lord, is with me. He's gonna show me the way. He's gonna deliver us. He's gonna make us victorious. But there is no time. The water is in front of them, the sea. They're gonna be drowned. And the Pharaoh is after them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in no time, Allah does not need a factory. Allah does not need manpower. Allah does not need a crane. Allah does not need anything. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا أَمْرُنَا لِشَيْءٍ إِذَا أَرَادِنَاهُ أَن نَقُولَ لَهُ كُمْ فَيَكُونَ. When Allah intend to do anything, Allah just say to it be, and it is. There is no treating, there is nothing to be done. Just a word. It is a word. Even before the word is done, it is done. It is manifested. إِنَّمَا أَمْرُنَا لِشَيْءٍ إِذَا أَرَدْنَاهُ أَن نَقُولَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. So what happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Musa, اضرب بعصاك البحر. Hit the water, O Moses, with your staff, with your cane, with your stick. اضرب بعصاك البحر. Behold, فانفلق فكان كل فرق كالطود العظيم وأزلفنا ثم الآخرين وأنجينا موسى ومن معه أجمعين. Look at that. Allah said to Musa, hit the water with your staff, and Musa عليه السلام cannot do anything but to hit. And behold, the water become frozen from both sides like a mountain. And اضرب لهم طريقا في البحر يبسا. The road is dry in front of them. There is no drop of water on the road. Then Musa alayhi salam delivered and reached the other side. And when Pharaoh came after, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Musa alayhi salam, when you are done, فاترك البحر رهوا إنهم جند مغرقون. When you are on the other side, leave the water as is, because Allah has a plan. This is the end of Pharaoh, the end of the dictator, the end of the transgressor, the oppressor. And that is a lesson for every dictator all over the world. A time will come when you cannot find anybody to help you. واترك البحر رهوا إنهم جند مغرقون. So Pharaoh followed them, but in the middle, the water went back to its nature and they drowned. So this is an example to show us. When it is too hard, when you look around, there is no light, there is no road, there is no any sign, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring about the solution. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to your rescue. Why? Because you have faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you have faith in somebody, he will try his best to come to your help. How about if that faith is in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty? This example of Musa alayhi salam should be clear in our mind whenever we face any hardship. When it becomes so dark, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring the daylight. When it becomes so tough, Allah will bring the ease. When it becomes so, there is no light in the end of the tunnel, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring the solution. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. That is about Musa alayhi salam. Another example that in the history also of the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, our father Ibrahim, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to take Hagar and her son Ishmael or Ismail to the desert. So he traveled all the way to Arabia, to the desert. And there he put them on the ground. What do we have? They have some water and some dates, some food, little food and little water. And he is turning back to go back. To go back to Palestine, to Palestine. So Hagar, his wife, stopped him and asked him, where are you going, Ibrahim? Ila aina? Where are you going and leaving us here? He didn't answer. He didn't answer. He ignored them. Why? Because Allah did not give him any order to say anything. He just carry out what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. Take them to the desert, take them to the desert. What happened, Ibrahim? He doesn't have anything to say. Then when she know him, she saw him, doesn't say anything, she asked him, Allahu amaraka bihada. That is what she is looking for. If that is an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu amaraka bihada. Did Allah command you to do that? To bring us all the way from Palestine to the desert and to go back and to leave us here in this deadly desert and to have little bit of food and water? Allahu amaraka bihada. What a great question. Why she is asking? Because she knows if it is a matter decided by Allah, she will accept. She will submit to the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why is that? Because she knows that Allah will never give up on them. That Allah is going to take care of them. Allahu amaraka bihada? Qala na'am. Qala na'am. Yes, that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to me. What did she say, Hagar? Qalat, إِذَنْ لَنْ يُضَيِّعَنَا. Then we are happy. Then we are assured, we are secure. Since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded you to bring us here, we do not worry. Why? Because Allah is gonna provide for us. And Ibrahim alayhi salam left. And while he is leaving his family in the desert, he raised his hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying, ربنا إني أسكنت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع عند بيتك المحرم. يا الله. What a great appeal to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ربنا, you are my Lord and the Hajar's Lord and my baby's Lord. You are the Lord of mankind. You are the Lord of the heavens and the earth. Inni askantu min dhurriyati. I am putting here my wife who just delivered a baby. And the baby, they need to be taken care of. They need to be served, to be looked after. Who is going to take care of them? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to make them happy. Not only happy. Allah is going to make them the seed for the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is going to make them memorable history for all believers until the end of the time. When the people, when the hujjaj, when the guests of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala go there and they run between Safa and the Marwa. And when they go there to drink from the water of Zamzam, when they are there to look at the house, who built it? It was Ibrahim alayhi salam and that baby that was left behind in the desert, but never been behind because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was taking care of him. رَبَّنَا إِنِّي أَسْكَنْتُ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرَّ عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةِ فَاجْعَلْ أَفْئِذَةً مِّنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِمْ وَارْزُقْهُمْ مِّنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَشْكُرُونَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala look after Hajar and her son Ismail alayhi salam. So this is the kind of faith, brothers and sisters. Finally, I would like to bring the recent one about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was forced to leave Mecca and he was there in the cave with his best friend Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu. And they were surrounded with the enemies coming from all over, and that will be the end for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They want to eliminate him from the whole existence. They want to put off forever something called Islam. And Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu looked at them and said, Ya Rasulullah, they are here. لو نظر أحدهم تحت موضع قدمه لرآنا. If just one of them look down under his feet, they're gonna get us. They're gonna see us. And you know, when they see us and take us, you know what is going to happen after that. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had full faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have relied on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا. ثانية اثنين إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا. Don't worry, don't be sad, because Allah is with us. So this kind of situation should be in our mind 24/7. Whenever we have any hardship, whenever we feel defeated, whenever we are in trouble, whenever we are discriminated against, whenever people call us names, whenever they point out to us to say those are terrorists or backward or those whatever, we should rely on the faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِلَّا تَنْصُرُوهُ فَقَدْ نَصَرَهُ اللَّهُ إِذْ أَخْرَجَهُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا ثَانِيَ اثْنَيْنِ إِذْ هُمَا فِي الْغَارِ إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا. What happened after that? فَأَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ سَكِينَتَهُ عَلَيْهِ وَأَيَّدَهُ بِجُنُودٍ لَمْ تَرَوْهَا وَجَعَلَ كَلِمَةَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا السُّفْلَى وَكَلِمَةُ اللَّهِ هِيَ الْعُلْيَا والله عزيز حكيم. The word of Allah always, everywhere, anywhere, anytime will be above. والله عزيز حكيم. لا تحزن إن الله معنا. That kind of faith that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم had. That kind of fear that Abu Bakr as-Siddiq رضي الله عنه had. And this kind of commitment to the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam believed in, he will never give up. Do not ever give up on what you believe in, even if the whole world are against you. الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسُ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَاخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. When the people said, be ready, the whole Arabia, the Qurayshites, the Jewish in Mecca and in Medina, the hypocrites, the Christian, all tribes are gathered together to eliminate you. إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا. That is the quality of the believer. When he is threatened, when he is put in fire, it makes him stronger. It makes him more committed. And that is what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said one day to his uncle. وَاللَّهِ يَا عَمِّي لَوَضَعُ الشَّمْسَ فِي يَمِينِي وَالْقَمَرَ فِي يَسَارِي على أن أترك هذا الأمر ما تركته أبدا. This is the kind of faith that the believer should have, and when we do, then we're gonna be, inshallah, the nation about whom Allah سبحانه وتعالى says, كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. You are the best nation that Allah سبحانه وتعالى brought up for mankind. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.